This is a 55 years old woman with known case of hepatitis C, now presenting with abdominal distension. Now there is gross ascites seen. Fluid is clear. Ascitic fluid is also extending up to peripatic space. Ascitic fluid around the liver gives a clear hepatic view on ultrasound scan. Ascites is one of the major complications of liver cirrhosis and portal hypertension. There is also mild right pleural fluid. Now in the hepatic scan, you can see the portal vein is dilated and there is complete thrombosis of main portal vein. Portal vein diameter is 16.5 mm. Normal, this is less than 12 mm. Portal vein thrombosis in this case is mainly located in main portal vein. It can extend in segmental hepatic branches, and in severe cases, if thrombosis extend up to spear mesenteric vein, there can be bowel ischemia. Portal vein thrombosis frequently occurs with cirrhosis of liver, more common in viral cirrhosis. Other causes include malignancy, abdominal sepsis, pancreatitis. The gallbladder is visualized. This is thick-walled, 10 mm contracted. Gallbladder wall thickening in this case is due to CLD and ascites. Liver is asymmetrical. Size is decreased, 13.1 cm. There are coarsening of texture and moderate to marked surface irregularity. Most important cause of liver cirrhosis include alcoholic and then viral hepatitis. As in this case, this is hepatitis C viral infection. Now this is a small slide hypoechoic nodule of size 10.1 mm. The more clear view is obtained, and there is a mild bulge from the interior surface. Small regenerating nodules are common in liver cirrhosis. These are microscopic, less than 3 mm, and macroscopic, 3 to 10 mm. But in this case, the nodule is mild atypical with some bulging from the interior surface. It needs to be further evaluated because liver malignancies are strongly associated with cirrhosis of liver. And this is fifth most common cancer in the world. The spleen is grossly enlarged, 16.6 cm. Note perisplenic collaterals, also a sign of portal hypertension.